Ladies and gentlemen, it is finally that magical time of the year, San Diego Comic-Con. Fans of pop culture from all over the world come far and wide to the beautiful land of San Diego to all crowd in a giant convention hall to hear exclusive news and watch clips and trailers that will inevitably be on YouTube like the next day. I'm just kidding, Comic-Con is an incredible event and there's always bound to be some incredible animation news. This year Comic-Con ran into a little bit of trouble, however, due to the not so subtle global pandemic that we're all going through. I remember when this whole thing started and I was like, well, there's no way they're gonna cancel Comic-Con, and then the months rolled on and I realized how dark it was. Now it's not even certain if we'll have a New York Comic-Con, which of course takes place in the fall, San Diego takes place in the summer, but that's not stopping them from rolling out the latest news on all things pop culture and specifically animation. That's because San Diego Comic-Con has opted to do a fully online experience that no one's really ever tried before, and it's going to be all free, which is the biggest part. So I guess we're all going to Comic-Con this year. It sounds like it should be better than it is. I don't know how to feel. But just to get you animation fans hyped and ready for this Comic-Con season, here at the Roundtable, we have congregated all of the animation panels and news that you should be looking out for this year. Animation is surprisingly stacked this year, honestly. There's a lot of panels to run through, and we want to take the time to remind you that actually logging in and showing up to these panels means a lot more than one would think. If you love supporting animation and supporting your favorite creators, this is the perfect way. So without further ado, here are the panels to look at and what they're all about. Coming up first, there's no way I could not mention this, the HBO Max and Cartoon Network Studios Infinity Train panel. Being an Infinity Train fan for the longest time meant just waiting. Waiting for the short to be greenlit, waiting for the show to come out, waiting for the other season, and waiting for confirmation on a season after that. Luckily for all of us, the Infinity Train is still chugging with a brand new season 3 premiering exclusively on HBO Max. And I'm gonna be honest, there's no panel I'm more excited for. So far, we've only seen the poster for this, and judging by the poster and the brief synopsis of this season's plot being somebody on the train without a number, this is gearing up to be the most exciting and interesting season of Infinity Train yet. The description for the panel reads, "The mysterious and compelling fan favorite series from Cartoon Network Studios and HBO Max pulls in for a triumphant return to Comic-Con this year." It then lists all the incredible people that are going to be on this panel, the hardworking members of the team, and including the creator, Owen Dennis. And here's the biggest bombshell, this is what made me actually jump from my seat. We are getting a sneak peek of book 3. I'm sorry for getting this cheesy, you guys. I love Infinity Train so much. We were absolutely blessed to get season 2 so close after season 1. And there's no animated series that I've been as hooked on as Infinity Train. The fact that we're getting a clip is so exciting because one, it could mean that they're further along in production, the fact that they have a clip, even if it's just an animatic. And hopefully we get a date on this because as of now, I'm pretty sure there's not a release date for this. It just says coming soon on the poster. I'm also very interested to see what's up with this gorilla, who's the animal companion this season, and I just can't express how much I love Infinity Train's setup of new characters, new plots, every single season. It's an anthology series. That's why I'm way more excited for this announcement than any other show, because I know we're going to be treated to something completely unique and different. So Infinity Train fans, make sure to check in Friday, July 4th from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Next up, speaking of shows we waited for, we gotta talk about Close Enough. Close Enough busted out on the scene just a few weeks ago, finally premiering on HBO Max, and the show did not disappoint. Check out our video on it if you're curious. I'm happy to announce that they are getting their own Comic-Con panel. This is a total no-brainer. I was not surprised. The panel promises discussion on the show and even a table read. Seeing as Close Enough is new on the block, it could use all the fan energy it can get. Seeing as season 2 is already done, we're definitely gonna get some season 2 info, maybe some clips or trailers, and maybe even a word on a possible season 3. Fingers crossed. Either way, with Close Enough being such a new show, I'm excited to see this whole fandom come together for pretty much the first time in a public forum like this. If you've been vibing with Close Enough, make sure to check in Thursday, July 23rd from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. for this panel. Next up, we have the Cartoon Network Studios First Look panel. If you're a fan of Cartoon Network, you will want to tune into this. It's a classic rundown of Cartoon Network shows, but more importantly, it's kind of an update on the whole HBO Max Cartoon Network merger and how that's going. They're finally coming together and announcing titles as a unit, and although we've seen some of these shows before, like Summer Camp Island, we'll be hearing from some new shows like Take and Seek and The Fungies. It's gonna be super exciting to see how this partnership is going, and I feel like a lot of Cartoon Network programming honestly gets slept on if it's not like super lore heavy or finds an older audience. But there's something to be said about shows like Summer Camp Island, which are delightful and fun and super entertaining, and have a ton of character and effort put into it, while still clearly aiming for probably a younger audience. If you want to be up to date with Cartoon Network, tune in Friday, July 24th from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. Next up, still on Cartoon Network, we have the Adventure Time Distant Lands panel. Now this one's going to be pretty fun, seeing as part of Distant Lands, the BMO special is already out. There's going to be a lot to talk about there, and from what I can tell, it's been very well received. A lot of people love that special. This panel promises an exciting roster of Adventure Time alumni, including new voice actors like Glory Curta, who voiced Y5 in the new Distant Lands special, and it even promises a sneak peek of the next special, which I cannot wait for. Mostly though, it's just cool seeing Adventure Time still being relevant at these cons, especially one as big as Comic-Con, and it just goes to show, even though the original series ran its course and ended, Adventure Time is a franchise that will live on for years and years and years, and this is not the last time we'll ever see you. If you want a little more Adventure Time in your life, tune in Friday, July 24th from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Speaking of continuing legacies, this next panel is another one that I'm extremely excited for, like words cannot describe. The Continuing the Avatar Legacy panel. Now guys, I truly think that this is gonna be huge. I've already made some videos talking about this, but with the recent Netflix success of the show and the live action show on the way, along with Avatar being more relevant than it has in years, I think we're gearing up for a brand new era of the show, and this panel certainly makes it sound like it. Now, according to the description, it looks like it could be kind of comics based, as it opens with Dark Horse Comics, Abram Books, and Nickelodeon, and that makes sense. The Avatar comics are a huge part of the story and lore. But we're also getting the creators and writers of Avatar for, quote, a further exploration of the beloved world as it has grown and changed since the animated series has ended. Interesting wording. I would certainly love a further exploration. I don't know what that could mean, but I'm dumb and naive and hope that they announce some next big Avatar series, even though that's not entirely likely. A boy can dream, can't he? Either way, there's no way they could have this panel without discussing the wild success Avatar has had on Netflix, and this is our first time we're gonna hear from them since this whole whirlwind sort of happened. What better place to talk about it than at Comic-Con? At the very least, maybe they'll hint to something or talk about something, even if it's just the new live-action series, which is enough to keep Avatar fans happy for a long time. I know I'm excited for it. If you're as curious as I am for the future of Avatar, tune in Friday, July 24th from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Next up, in the world of adult animation, we have the new Star Trek Universe Lower Decks series. Now, this show caught a lot of flack at first for looking similar to Final Space, but I was just excited to see more adult animated sci-fi. And the more I looked into the show, the more excited that I got. It's premiering on CBS All Access, making it pretty much another streaming original. And despite its Final Space-y look, I feel like this could be a very different show, and at the very least, a very funny show. But this all boils down to the fact that I'm putting my full faith into the series creator, Mike McMahon. If you're unfamiliar with this person's name, well, you're gonna be learning it soon. He's Rick and Morty alumni and co-creator of Solar Opposites, a brilliant writer and storyteller. He really carries that style that those shows have and is a huge part of shaping those shows. Just because his name isn't the creator on Rick and Morty doesn't take away from the fact that he was a big part of it. And he appears to be very in demand right now and having a lot of success on his own after co-creating his own Hulu original series and being the sole creator of this one. If you're interested, definitely check out the trailer. I think it looks funny and I'm excited for it, and I will be tuning into this panel for sure. Speaking of Solar Opposites, if you were a fan of the Hulu original, then you should definitely check in to the Solar Opposites panel. This was, in my opinion, one of the freshest and funniest cartoons to come out this year, especially in terms of adult animation. I've talked about it plenty on the channel, I am a huge fan, and I feel like the fan base is only growing, so I guess we'll see how this panel turns out. Again, this is another show that was confirmed for a season 2 even before it aired, so they're going to have a lot to talk about. Hopefully this panel will have some memeable clips, you know, Justin's gonna do some voice or something, that will pull more viewers in for the show while simultaneously showing how much of a fan base already exists around it. I'm kind of anticipating this to be like one of the classic Rick and Morty panels, which are always vastly entertaining to watch. Hopefully they do some sort of improv, especially with the voice actors. And yeah, according to the description, they have confirmed that they're going to be playing a clip from the upcoming second season, which the creators have talked about as being more put together and more unique as season 1. If you're a fan of Solar Opposites, check in Thursday, July 23rd from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Now we're gonna move on to more of the primetime animation circuit. The first panel we're discussing here is Duncanville. This Fox cartoon sitcom came out in 2020, but it's already doing great. It's been praised critically, and I have yet to check it out, but I definitely plan on it. The thing that's gonna make this panel so exciting is Duncanville's star-studded cast. We're getting Amy Poehler, Ty Burrell, Wiz Khalifa. It's gonna be kind of wild. And again, I don't know how they're gonna do this virtually. Maybe it's gonna be a weird Zoom call, but this will definitely be an interesting panel just for the cast alone. For Duncanville fans, make sure to check on Thursday, July 23rd from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Also in the same vein, we have Bless the Hearts, another Fox animated family sitcom. This show came out in 2019, again to favorable reviews, and is renewed for a season 2, so this panel will definitely be interesting. This is another show I haven't seen yet, but I really need to. It is slept on. And from the description, this panel sounds delightful. Nothing too crazy, just a good time overall. If you want to keep up with the Hearts, check in Saturday, July 25th from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Then we have a couple of mainstay panels. Shows like Bob's Burgers, The Simpsons, Family Guy, and American Dad. I don't mean to group these in, I know they're all separate shows, but if I'm being honest, there is not too much to say about all of these shows. They've been airing for so many years at this point that their appearance at Comic-Con is pretty much par for the course. You'll get a table read with the cast, a sneak peek to the upcoming season, which for these shows means any number higher than 10, pretty much. Truth be told, if you're a fan of any of these shows, you're definitely just gonna be watching the Comic-Con panel anyways. I don't have to remind you. And yeah, they should all be a great time. But if you want to talk the antithesis of primetime animation, let's talk Adult Swim, because they're doing some pretty revolutionary stuff. First up is the panel for the show YOLO Crystal Fantasy. Now, if you were a fan of the incredibly weird Bushworld Adventures Rick and Morty April Fool's joke they did a few years ago, you will love this show because the creator of that, Michael Cusack, created YOLO Crystal Fantasy. If the name wasn't weird enough for you, then you better buckle up. The show is yet to premiere, but follows two Australian party girls, and I'm sure we'll get all the information we need from this panel. The first episode is out, but the show itself premieres on August 9th, so hopefully this can build up some hype and get the word out, because Michael Cusack has a style of comedy that is lovably surreal and always infinitely entertaining to watch. I cannot wait to see what he does when given his own show. If you're as excited for the show as I am, tune into the panel Friday, July 24th from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Then for OG fans of Adult Swim, there's the 12 Ounce Mouse panel, something I really never thought I would see. That's because 12 Ounce Mouse is getting a reboot after all these years. This infamous Adult Swim cartoon was very polarizing, airing originally in 2005, but recently there was 10 new episodes of the show greenlit for 2020, and I will definitely be tuning in to see how that goes. As for the panel itself, it's a pretty standard Comic-Con panel. For fans of 12 Ounce Mouse, the panel is being held Friday, July 24th from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. In other sectors of adult animation, we have another show that I have to check out that I haven't yet, the interesting stop-motion animated comedy, Crossing Swords. Now this Hulu stop-motion original, which is one of the most unique descriptions for any cartoon I've heard in a while, already aired its first season with its second on the way. It's from the producers of Robot Chicken, and it looks like they're just going to be discussing the show as a whole, as well as hyping up and giving details for the second season. I don't know about you, but for me, as somebody who wants to get into the show, my plan is to watch season 1 and then catch season 2 as it airs, because I've seen clips online and this thing looks like a trip. If you want to check out Crossing Swords, their panel is Friday, July 24th from 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. Now let's move on to some more HBO Max stuff. HBO Max is having an entire panel dedicated to its adult animation. Now honestly, this is a lot of stuff we've seen before, like Robot Chicken, Samurai Jack, Primal, and Final Space, but that's just because of the merger between HBO Max and Cartoon Network, because all of these are Adult Swim shows. Just because they're under a different title now doesn't mean we can't get an equally as hyped panel, and seeing these shows discussed in any context, especially with creators like Genndy Tartakovsky there, it's definitely going to be a ride. For all things HBO Max adult animation, tune in Friday, July 24th from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. HBO Max also has an entire panel dedicated to a new batch of Looney Tunes cartoons. Now, I've never really been a OG Looney Tunes fan. I know it's a brand that's much bigger than me, so obviously I grew up knowing who all the characters were, but it's always been kind of like Scooby-Doo in the sense that they've been able to refresh them every couple of years and give us a new rendition. My absolute favorite is the Looney Tunes show because it's just Bugs Bunny Seinfeld. It's beautiful. They've actually produced a number of Looney Tunes shorts so far, so there's going to be a lot to watch there. In fact, some of them are available on YouTube, and they're definitely throwbacks to the original Looney Tunes style. They're very exciting to see, and I'm excited to see more. If you're curious about what the future of Looney Tunes looks like, check in Sunday, July 26th from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Next up, and this is kind of tied into HBO because it's a part of HBO Max, we have the Crunchyroll panel. One word, baby. Anime. This is the anime panel. Hell yeah, dude. Hear about the latest and greatest anime and manga coming out of Crunchyroll straight from the source. How could you not get excited about that? They're promising special prize giveaways, virtual goodies. I mean, it's anime. What are you doing if you're not tuning into this? This is gonna be definitely the best panel. 1000% all the way. Super hyped. I will be checking in. Crunchyroll has expanded so much since it first began all those years ago, and now is pretty much an anime empire, so if anybody could put on a good panel, even virtually, it's them. If you want to check out the Crunchyroll panel, it's Thursday, July 23rd from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. And guys, I want to wrap all of this up with one last panel that I cannot wait for. 4, another classic, Phineas and Ferb the movie, Candace Against the Universe. We thought we said goodbye forever to our favorite Danville residents, but that turned out to not be the case when they announced a new Disney Plus exclusive Phineas and Ferb movie, Candace Against the Universe. It was inevitable that they would return to this world. I mean, this is such a huge franchise, everybody loves Phineas and Ferb, and there's so much more to explore. If you're actually on social media, especially TikTok, you've probably seen some of this movie already, as Dan Povenmire has been pretty active on social media showing scenes of him animating it, and overall it just gives me more hype than ever. Everything that's come out about this movie so far has been interesting, but the reason I'm so excited for this panel is because we're gonna get a ton more information and probably even some clips on the movie, as the panel promises an exclusive sneak peek. It even mentions going into the origins of Phineas and Ferb, which is always infinitely interesting. For Phineas and Ferb fans, this panel is Saturday, July 25th, from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. And guys, one more panel I want to talk about. Don't crucify me, it's not animation, but The Boys has been my favorite show to come out in the last year, easily. This dark, satirical take on superheroes is just absolutely airtight. It's an incredibly engaging, interesting, fun watch, and it's superheroes done in a way I've never seen before, so I couldn't talk about Comic-Con without mentioning how excited I was for The Boys panel. After seeing the season 2 trailer and the clip that's come out of it, I'm not even telling you to watch it. If it's not your cup of tea, it's not, but either way, I will definitely be tuning into this panel. Well guys, that looks like all the information on Comic-Con. What's that? I'm sorry, do we have a new contender coming in the ring? What is that? Alarm sound blaring. Oh my gosh, it's Adult Swim with their own convention. Why are they so amazing? That's right, Adult Swim that has been infamously known to go hard every Comic-Con. I mean, just look at like the attractions and things they've always set up. Much respect to them. They've managed to make do with the events of coronavirus, which of course is stopping them from going all out like they usually do, by going all out virtually with Adult Swim Con. The convention has an insane lineup. The full list includes Rick and Morty, Robot Chicken, Flying Lotus, YOLO Crystal Fantasy, a DJ set, Cosplay Cup, a Samurai Jack Showcase, Toonami Edition, live events, surprise musical guests, giveaways, and even a chance to chat with cast and creators. San Diego Comic-Con is doing the most, but Adult Swim's really putting in the 110% here. This is going to be an event that I will remember for a long time. And unlike the previous events that Adult Swim has thrown, where you kind of had to be in San Diego and at Comic-Con to participate in them, this is something that anybody with an internet connection can tune into and be a part of. And that's the silver lining with all of this. As sad and scary as these times are, guys, we're all going to San Diego Comic-Con, and there's a lot to love about that. I've only listed some of the panels that are at this convention, but there's so many more, along with events and other things that just make you feel a part of your favorite community. So let's not let this flop, let's all go to Comic-Con together, because the best part of any show is its community. But that being said, speaking of community, I want to know what you guys think about all of this. Are you excited for some of these panels? Are you not? Let us know in those comments down below. Tweet to us at RoundtableVids or me at StretcherNemo. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like, share it, and subscribe to the Roundtable for more incredible cartoon content. As always guys, I'm Nemo, this is a San Diego Comic-Con Rundown, and I will see you next time. Peace.